Diabetes mellitus refers to a group of diseases that affect how your body uses blood sugar or glucose. Too much sugar or glucose can lead to serious problems. We spoke to Dr. Sam Chia at Methodist Hospital in Arcadia, California, and asked him to tell us more about diabetes.
There's two types. There's type 1, where kids get it because their pancreas stops producing insulin. But the type that I want to concentrate on today is type 2 diabetes, where your body still makes insulin, but the insulin is not doing a proper job, so body's blood sugar rises abnormally and the metabolism is completely screwed up. Current recommendation is to have a fasting blood sugar number of 110 or less to be counted as normal. If you're above 125, that would be in the diabetic range. Between 110 and 125, you're in the pre-diabetic range. If you get higher number than 125, then that's diabetes. Hypoglycemia is a number that is too low. We don't want that because a person can go into coma, can faint, can have heart attack. Unfortunately, early symptoms are not felt by a person, and only during late phases do a lot of symptoms show up. Diabetes affects multiple organ systems in your body. It can damage your nerves, including your peripheral nerves that goes to your feet, hands. It can damage your blood vessels, and blood vessels are everywhere. So it can damage the blood vessels in your eyes, causing blindness. You can damage the blood vessels in your kidney, causing kidney failure and end up on dialysis. You can cause blood vessel damage to your heart, so it can lead to heart attack. Same thing happens in the brain, which leads to stroke. If blood vessel damage occurs in your legs, that's how people get ischemic limbs and end up with unhealing sores and therefore amputation. So, almost every body system you can imagine, it can affect. It is familial if your first degree family members, father, mother, brother, siblings, had diabetes, then your chance of developing diabetes is much higher than somebody who doesn't have a family history. If you are a woman and had gestational diabetes, meaning developing diabetes during pregnancy, you have much higher chance of developing diabetes later on in life. I would hope that a person would test themselves regularly with a doctor and detect pre-diabetic states so that they can start those lifestyle changes even before. Lifestyle changes meaning you have to eat differently. You can't digest or metabolize sugar normally, so you should minimize sugary intake. You should lose weight. You should exercise. And probably start some medication as well. But diabetes is one of those diseases where you can take 3, 4, 5 medication faithfully. But if you're eating wrong, if you're not exercising, not watching your weight, you can still be very poorly controlled. So exercise and the right diet and weight maintenance is very, very important in diabetes. You can't just rely on medication. CDC is quoting for 2014 the prevalence rate of greater than 9% in this country. So almost 1 out of 10 person in the United States has diabetes. So just looking at your mom and dad is not enough. You have to look in yourself.